Good morning, Mr. President. Welcome po. Sir, napag-usapan niyo ba ng Prime Minister ng Malaysia yung about sa MRT project nila for the Philippines? And kumusta ho yung meeting? Ano pa ho yung mga napag-usapan niyo?
Well, most would really be focused on infrastructure pati agribusiness. Lahat yan, and there's a lot of projects on deck. So I would say that it would keep our country busy in the coming months. But by the way, I have to remind you that if there will be a lot of projects on the streets, there will also be commotion and sometimes derailment of the traffic situation. But I said that is just a warning, and people will continue to complain, but then wala namang libre dito. There's always a drawback. But I'm sure that with the implementation in the coming year, and I would place it that maybe next year early,
kasama
we would
na
have seen the developments.
Kasama na ho yun sa MRT project nila po, ano?
Kasama ho yun. Yan ang mauna that talaga because it involves mass transport, moving people.
How about po dun sa ano, may plano ba sila to invest on palm oil?
Ang tagal na nga yan eh. Problem actually, let me be very frank. Noon may pumasok na dito. And as a matter of fact, they sent their agronomist. The guy who examines the soil for its appropriate plant. Ang nangyari sa pakibato, para wala na tayong bulahan dito. The Malaysians were ready at the time. And after a positive finding sa suitability sa soil, what happened is that suddenly, ang mga NPA, alam na, yung banners nila everywhere, simply no to palm oil. And I asked them, bakit? Sabi nila, sabi na ng mga expert, ang problema kasi nitong maraming experts, lalo na sa internet, every time Dick and Harry, who knows about a little of everything and everything so little, may sarili-sariling Malaysia has prospered. It has not lost its moisture or water. Hindi ko talaga malaman na kung bakit. Ako naman, even with my assurance, for as long as there is always the threat, then we cannot do anything. Ganun no ang nangyari dyan, ma'am. But they will try again. And again, I will make sure to meet the experts of the world about water under the soil and ask us to explain why it is so. Kasi yung sa Agusan banda, I think it's del Sur, matagal ng palm oil dyan sa ano, it has proven to be a good source of revenue and a source of livelihood for the people there. To delay based on something which is not really accepted by everybody, and to the detriment also of government plans to alleviate standard of living ng tao, and nakabuhol-buhol eh. I really do not know, but I think somebody should talk to them again. Maybe this would be one project that we can ask about doon sa Oslo. Because while waiting for the final result, ano man yan, kailangan natin na we have to improve the lives of the people. Ako actually, kung ang sitwasyon ganito lang, pati pag alis ko, I will consider myself really a total failure. If I cannot improve, even a few bars, not just above. There's one thing for me to do is tutuhanan ito, ha. Either resign or give it to somebody else. Masyadong mabigat ang problema. At kung marami namang aktor, eh, di kayo na lang. Totoo yan. I have no illusions about this presidency. I will work because I was elected. Why I run, I cannot tell you why. I'm even asking myself. But I'm trying to do my very best. But if I think that I'm a failure or I cannot hack it, might as well give it to somebody else. There is no dishonor to be honest to oneself.
Ms. Rita Reyes of GMA.
Hi, sir. Welcome back, sir. Sir, I know that you've already said your congratulations to President-elect Trump, but may I ask you if you're comfortable whenever people compare you with him?
Compare me with Trump?
Yes.
Sus Maria Josep, ma'am. I'm just a small molecule in this planet. He is now the president of the most powerful country in the world. I am just a president struggling to barely to just above the water. We have to worry about ourselves first. But comparison, no, I don't think we. Well, what we share in common maybe is the passion to serve, and it's given. When you run for a public office, you're expected to. Sometimes it goes with the, you know, sama loob mo, despondent at times, sometimes just plain. Tired. But most of the time, it is always hindi kontento kung I have to push more.
Mm-hmm. Sir, what is your anticipation of the expected change in foreign policy that will be implemented by the incoming U.S. President?
No, I will pursue what I've started. I am not into the habit of reneging on my word. And my partnership with China and the rest of the ASEAN remains. I will sail the state of the nation and it should be pushed by the wind of self-interest only. The self-interest of our nation.
Last question for me. Have you committed to attending the APEC next week?
That's I've been talking about it in the airplane. It's a long way across the globe. It's a long haul, and it will kill you. By the time you reach the, I will decide. I ask Toto, ha? Sabi ko kay Secretary Doresa, pati kay Secretary Asay, sabi niya, si kay Jess, ayaw ko part. Tapos sabi rin ni Junya Asay, hindi pwede yan. Kailangan nandoon ka. Kasi dapat mayroon kang pakikitaan na tao doon. Sino? May binigay siya na pangalan. So,
is it going to be the outgoing president, sir, of U.S.?
Who?
Is it going to be President Obama for a possible bilateral meeting?
No. I think... hindi, talagang... Kung kaya lang sana nila, without my presence, if my presence is indispensable, I'd rather not kasi malayo. I hate long hauls. Talagang hindi ko kaya yung At saka malayo masyado, mag-ikot kami sa, sabi nila, ang ruta namin is through New Zealand. Because if you may the Pacific, ang point of entry dyan sa North America is America, United States. Ang exit mo could be Kennedy Airport, New York, or Miami. Wala akong nakikitang view doon. Mas yung Auckland, maybe then, ang problema, baka magtuloy-tuloy ang sa South Pole. Sila na lang muna mauna doon kasi malamig. Well, really, I said, I just a joke. Alam mo, pagka gano'n, naano talaga ako kasi ang, diba, bunga ako ah. Haluan talaga ng, hindi ko ba sinasadya. Pero, it's actually the long haul that worries me.
Thank you, sir.
Ruth Lumandan of RGMA.
Morning, President. I'd like to ask your stand or your position on the coconut levy fund.
It should be returned to the people. The law is actually clear. There is a committee composing of the executive department, tapos yung Congress, at saka a few representatives from the private sector. My position is very clear noon pa. I want the money returned immediately to the people. But the problem is, ang decision nagsabi, you cannot determine anymore the many coconut farmers who were affected at the time or who were prejudiced. So ang ginawa, Supreme Court to, made some suggestion of how to go about it. Improving the quality of the coconuts, funding projects related to the coconut industry. Pero yung pera, medyo malabo na yun. The Supreme Court said so. Pero kung sa uli, I want it returned. By way of building institutions, agencies that would enhance the coconut industry. Asap ako dyan kasi pera ng tao yan. Pati kami nag-contribute dyan sa levy na yan. Yung pamilya namin.
Okay.
May mother's coconut, not ours.
Okay, second question. I'd like to follow up on Trump, President. How do we foresee relationship Philippines and America with Trump's administration? Would
as
it be
is.
Friendly?
As is. We are friends with an ally. We have an RPUS military pact that was 1954, I think, vintage, that would bind us in the matter of saying whether or not you side with this or that. But I do not foresee any war in the next 100 years. So we will maintain our cooperation of the committee. The respect should be there, and in all matters that would affect our two countries, especially the treaties that we signed with them, and the so many agreements, it will be honored, all of these things.
Trisha Perada of CNN Philippines.
Good morning, sir. Sir, Secretary Lorenzana mentioned that the implementation of EDGA will push through. Are you confirming this, sir, or will there be limitations to the implementation of EDGA?
No, I said, because by the time we were, I talked to the Secretary of National Defense, mm-hmm. they were na firm up na nila ang arrangement. Mm-hmm. And I said, I do not want na mapahiya ang Pilipinas. Well, of course, not so much because I was already vocal against it, but in deference to the Secretary of Defense. Mm-hmm. Sabi ko, oh, sige, but this will be the last time. And I expect that by the time that I end my term, I do not want to see any any, not only US, even African or Chinese or whatever, present. I do not want to see foreign military troops in my country.
Mm-hmm. Mr. Can we see clarification also for the continuation of military training? Will this still exclude military exercises? And sir, what prospects do we see that now we have a new president when it comes to military ties? Do we see reunited ties with President Trump?
Wait. Let us put aside Trump here. Mm-hmm. Actually, in every military exercise, whatever, mm-hmm. it is always America who learns much. Kukunti lang yung sa Pilipino, kasi kanya may yung palawan. Ano mo i-training mo dyan? The one thing that really is, that bothers you is that yung communications nila, pati yung state of the art, because they are rich, maybe they were advanced in time, on space, ano yung kanila, sophisticated. Ours, they are not compatible. Ngayon sila pwedeng magkukunik-kunik dyan, and even the matter of communication, you'll have to use the basics na unalaman nila. But the United States is using an altogether new gadgets. We have not been provided by them. It's expensive. But I'm looking forward to other countries. I could get it from Japan, China, I could get it from Russia, or the Middle East, Israel. Hindi na kailangan tayo mag-ano, kasi hindi na pwede tayo maghingi na maghingi. You know, this paradigm of hand-me-down, and I tell the military and the police, stop it. Kung wala ni bayonet na lang, antuhan kumbat. Kaya siya we always go there to study, and our bright boys there, guys, our soldiers, make so many, you know, advanced projections. Yung mga thesis nila, nakinabang, hindi naman tayo. Actually, ha, we do not need anybody to train the Filipino soldier. By themselves, they are warriors and capable of a conventional war. Kung rebellion lang, I do not expect any war against any other nation. Terrorism, drugs, kaya. Kailangan yan ng turuplano nga. Yan lang naman ang pinoproject ko. The most serious is, if it comes, itong terrorism. But what is bugging us now is really Andruga. And I cannot tell you my next move, but I will try to invite and ask everybody to participate. Yung pinakita ko dito na ganun kakapal, hindi ko kaya yun. I mean, if I use the contemporary rules, constitutional, di ba? Hindi ko talaga kaya. Kasi gusto mong patayin. Maubusan ka ng panahon, hindi mo kaya patayin lahat. At, you know, if you do that, whether it is justified or not, the Human Rights Commission of the United Nations will always be there. And I said, kung habulin mo naman lahat, remember, I am warning you again. We have become a narco-politic nation. Many of those involved are barangay captains. Halos lahat. Nakikinabang kasi. Police, mga official meron pa. to the level of bakit ba tinanggal yung dating, remember me, Secretary Andanar to ask Congress to balik tayo doon sa police corporal, police court. Sino bang gumawa nitong SPO1? Instead na regular na police, ginawang special police, special SP1, SP2, SP3. Sino yan si SP? Esperanza? Doon nata kumuha ng gago yung... No, there should be something like... I'd like to tell government, especially the police. Kayo, do not... ayoko lang masaktan kayo. But may ano talaga kayo, may... You do not have a very consistent... Maganda naman yung police general, director general. Maganda naman yung police chairman. Kasi yung... Tingnan mo yung sila pula po. Naawa ako dyan. Kasi yung... Yung siya sa... Insignia ba yan? Hindi nga ako nakatapos ng ROTC. Kaya ang ganun eh. Baga, ito ngayong bagong director general, sila pula po nakaganon. Bilis na naman sila ng bagong patch. Pag supasok ng ibang director, another administration, sila pula po muhat siya na. Nakaganon na. You know, alam ko, you know, people are not idiots, you know. Filipino people, stop it. Stop it. Kaya at yung police na kalit-lit na sweldo, magbili ng mga bagong, stop it. If you want, I will increase your salaries threefolds. Just stop it. That's yung corruption. It is corruption. Tuntuan ninyo yan. Kaya huwag ninyong gawin sa akong panahon na. Nanay ko last a lawmaker to balik tayo doon sa police constable, police. Tanong, kagaya ng report ninyo, ha? Raid conducted in Menorapa, Pediasito, Soto. Soto, ano tapos, Soto. You know, just say, I'd like to direct you now. Just say, Davao del Norte, the municipality of malaman na yan, o CIDG. Man, aid, suot dito. Hindi ko malam, basahin ko yung briefer. Akala ko, asosasyon ng mga bugok itong putang inang buso. Basta nakakainis kayo. Pati ako nalilito, kaya magtawag pa akong leche. Ano ba itong, sinong nag-ano na itong brief, ano dito? Eh, may summary ako sa lahat ng namatay pati buhay itong araw na ito eh. Sino itong age soft? Test ka muna, sir. Ha? Yung tinawagan ko, wala aling alam. Ay, sus, Mario Joseph. You better go back to this month. Police patrolman, constable, or whatever. And I have plans of, I said, if the terrorism will creep in, I will maybe create, instead of the south, I will create the back Philippine constabulary.
Pearl Gahunera of Manila Standard.
And it will be under the armed forces again. So, apat balik tayo sa apat. Army, Navy, Air Force, pati PC.
Good morning, sir. Sir, you have given the green lights to Malaysia to deport the around 7,000 Filipinos who are in Sabah who illegally migrated there.
Yes, we are almost an hour. Okay lang sa kanila. And I said, no clemency, except that give us time to... ang problema doon, kasi yung mga Pilipino, walang edukasyon. And we cannot expect also Malaysia to absorb them because hindi sila Filipino citizens. They should be learning what our history, not the history of somebody else's country. But they are there. So I will ask the government to intervene. We will have to put up schools there. And sa ospital naman, nakakahiya naman na puro hindi tinga nakaroon. That's an added cost to them. So we will ask a neutral country, maybe neutral agency, rather, WHO, whatever, to establish hospitals there. Pero atin ang mga tao ipadala na i-deploy natin yun. The nurses, kawawa eh. Kawawa yung mga tausog doon na. No? Most of them are tausog. But they are Filipinos. And they should be attended to.
Last questions from Dexter Ganibe of DZMM.
Chairman Guntag. Sir, clarification lang dun sa bubuing trilateral arrangement or agreement, yes, with Indonesia and Malaysia. Paano po ang maging system nun kung may habulin ng mga kidnappers or Abu Sayyaf coming from Malaysia or Indonesia at papasok sa teritoryo? Paano po yung arrangement natin dun?
I cannot talk about it. Kasi the Defense Secretary of our country and the Ministry of Defense of Indonesia and Malaysia have yet to firm up something there. And it would be good not to discuss it. Even if there's already one existing, I would rather big off.
All right, sir. Thank you very much.
Any more questions?
That would be all, Mr. President.
Kama, meron ka pa?
Rita.
No? Malgan. Ramihan mo para on newspaper na naman tayo dito.
Sir, last question po talaga. Sir, in today's Senate hearing on the killing of Mayor Espinosa, the senators are convinced that the what happened was premeditated. And the
murder, you mean? Rabaul?
Yes, the murder. And apart from that, Kerwin Espinosa will be fetched in Abu Dhabi to come back in the Philippines.
And he has plenty to tell.
Yes, yeah. According to him. How does the government plan to provide him with the security that he needs and his his request for to be provided assistance?
I think there's a team of NBI plus the two other officers of the PNP. I'm sure, I guarantee you, he will be brought. Takot ka, baka ihulog dyan pag uwi sa Pacific. Buksan mo pa yung porta dyan. No, he will be repatriated. I'm sure of that. They are just working. It's not that easy to extract a guy na illegal doon, tapos dalhin mo. Yeah, there are rules to be followed. But he will be back to face the charges. Now, yung dito sa Senate, let me state my case as the chief executive of the executive branch. I believe in the version of the police. If they have evidence to prove otherwise, then a case should be filed against the police. But as I have said before, right at the start, very early on sa administration ko, I will protect and I will support the police in this drive against Cebu. As I have said, we have become a narco-politic state. It is my sworn duty to preserve the generation. It is my sworn duty to see to it that we do not slide just like the other countries of the world, particularly Latin America. So walang dapat ikatakot ang mga polis. Suportado ko sila. At kung sabihin nila bakit si Duterte isang suportahan yung polis, natural. Utos ko yun eh. the fight against drug is mine. It was not somebody else's order. I pushed the police to the limits. And as a matter of fact, if anybody should go to prison, I should be the one. Ako ang nag-utos eh. So I assume full legal responsibility. Ako akin yun. So if I rot in prison, so be it. At least, ang pinangako ko sa inyo sa taong bayan, that I will stop corruption, I will stop drugs and criminality. And I said, if I lose the presidency, if it means going to jail, fine. What is important to me is my word of honor na hindi tayo masisira as a nation. Because by then, it would be too late for everybody. Doon, mayor, nag-oath-taking sa umaga, pagkahapon, patay. Ang admiral sa Mexico, pinutula ng ulo. Kasi ang humihirit doon yung Marines. Why? Because they have corrupted all of the police there. And the armed forces had to utilize another unit to do the job for the police. I will not allow that to happen in my country. So, it's actually mine. Huwag kayong tumutok sa police. Just wait for their explanation. Just wait for their version. In the meantime, if you run out of people to blame, look at me because I was the one who ordered the war against drug. I did not pronounce any police punitive action because that is why the armed forces are into it also. Same, they will have my protection and I assume full legal and daily responsibility. Maraming salamat po.